Some people just aspire to ascend, even if that requires axes and spikes and involves some real risk. Chris O'Connell is one of those people. He sees vertical ice and just wants up.
You know, you have days like this, it's like, it's magic, it's really nice.
He's climbed towering frozen rock faces all over North America. To show you how he does it, he shows me. But before we get here, let's rewind. We begin at Central Rock Gym in Randolph.
Okay, I hereby authorize and grant permission to the gym to secure emergency medical treatment for me.
Simulating an ice climb in a controlled environment, not a bad idea for a novice.
You want them snug, but not really tight. Getting a sense of climbing, learning some of the rope management, and just the language.
Actual ice axes can be modified for indoor climbs.
This is a Black Diamond Cobra. It's a pretty common tool. We've replaced the ice climbing pick or blade with one that's made for climbing on indoor holds.
The fail-safe to fall-safe, a technique called belaying. Harness on.
This is gonna catch me.
It
and
should
you.
Catch you, yes.
Chris keeps a tight grip on a rope secured to me and to the top of the wall.
As you climb, I'll take in the rope. I'll keep it secured.
Okay.
Certainly not speedy, but steady. Hooking hold by hold, the idea is to push with the legs.
There you go, good.
And not pull with the arms. Focus forward. Not down.
All right.
Woo! The descent, pretty much a trust exercise. Okay, let go and drop. And then cue the celebration.
Good job.
All right,
nice.
Thank you.
Yeah,
Cindy Sue knows that feeling of accomplishment. She's been rock climbing for about 5 years.
I learned a lot about myself. For someone who's been pretty insecure about my body for a while, this is definitely a way for me to help be comfortable with my own body and be able to push myself.
She's honing her ice climbing skills with larger goals in mind.
I'm really interested in doing mountaineering, and this is a skill you really need to have.
All right, to the real ice.
Some of the best ice around forms in New Hampshire's Crawford Notch State Park. A hike's in order. We carefully traverse the trestle at Frankenstein Cliff, Mount Washington kissing a perfect bluebird sky up ahead. The sunshine welcome on a sub-freezing day.
Ice climbing has grown in popularity, and this is kind of the center of the New England ice climbing scene.
But it's not for everyone. There's the cold, the equipment's expensive, and there's always the chance of an accident.
Climbing is never really safe. You're mitigating the risk as best you can.
Cindy, now accompanied by her ice climbing boyfriend, Alex Smith, reminds me why we're here.
You are learning a new set of skills. You're learning about yourself, and I think that's something super awesome.
The features are so beautiful. I mean, there are these huge ice climbs, 100 feet high. So it's just a fun thing to do, and it's a good way to push yourself.
Some of this looks familiar from the gym.
Right.
But
yeah.
Not everything.
Somewhat familiar, at least, yes.
The harness is exactly the same. The clothes, clearly not.
We went from a tank top to 5 layers.
And the footwear, way more serious. These are called crampons.
To summarize a lot, you're gonna swing with the swingies and you're gonna kick with the kickies.
Okay.
So it's kind of get it in and then stand up. That's good. That's a good kick right there, down a hair. That's good, I think. Go ahead, stand up on that. Nice, good. So now do it again.
Finding the sweet spot to strike takes practice.
Oh, again. Do you feel that when it goes in like that?
I do.
And that's your next tool placement. Give it a good swing into that.
You got me right, Chris?
I got you nice and tight.
Feeling the fatigue, a key tip is release the grip one hand at a time. The pain of losing blood flow to the fingers has a pretty descriptive name.
I don't want you getting the screaming barfies.
Oh boy.
Shake them. That's great. That's exactly what you want to do.
After a quick descent, I realize I should have shaken them a little more.
Really good.
Made it. Oh, my fingers.
Okay, so hopefully they're not the full-on screaming barfies. When your hands are above your heart and it's cold out and you're gripping, the blood stops flowing, and then when you come down, the blood starts and it really hurts. So you feel like screaming and throwing up at the same time.
I don't feel like throwing up, but ow.
Yeah, it hurts, huh?
Alex and Cindy assure me this pseudo-torture is a type of fun.
Type one fun is like, yay, this is awesome. This is gonna be a great, I wanna keep doing this.
Type two fun is it's scary in the moment, but you look back at it and you got something out of it. Maybe you froze your hands, but you'll look back at it tonight, you're like, oh, that was really cool.
It was certainly cold, and looking back, okay, fun too.